Hello, because customers of our Taipan air guns ask us for some service videos, so now we will try to make a video how to adjust the trigger system, how to change the sight or the position of the side lever from left to right side, how to change O-rings or other features, and so we will try to show you how to reassemble the gun and also how to assemble gun. So let me show it. So now we can start to disassemble this gun, and I will try to show you how easy it is, what you can change and how you can change it. So during the assembling and disassembling, we'll just use the normal keys and other things, no special tools. Just we have one special tool for pressure gauge, but it is also not necessary to have it. So now at first you must take out the side lever. So it's very easy. It's just on the two screws. I will use this automatic screw, but it's also can be done manually. So first one, then second, you must hold it on the other side. So both are unscrew. So the screws, I will put it in tin boxes from the GSB pellets. You see it's also useful. There is a side lever. And now you must take out two main screws for the wood stocks. So the one is here. And the second one. Also, I will take it out to the tin boxes. And then you can take out the wood stock. It's very easy. Now we will continue with the barrel, or at first I will show you something about our trigger system. As a lot of people said that our trigger system is the best one, so I will show you how complicated it is. It looks a little bit complicated, but for settings it's very easy. You can set up four things on the trigger system. Okay, so we open the door, and here you can see the trigger system. There is four points which you can set up. The first point is here, is how soft it can be the first stage of the trigger system. So it is about the softness. Here it is about the length of the first stage of the trigger system. Then the third one is about how sensitive is the trigger. And the last one is here, and it is about the depth of the last stage of trigger system. You can see all the parts of the trigger system is very accurate and from the high quality material. So don't worry about it. Sometimes when you open the door, these parts can drop down, but it's very easy to put it on the right place. So this is the trigger system. Once more, the first one is about softness of the first stage. The second point is about the length of the first stage. Then it's about the sensitive of the trigger. And then the last one is about the depth of the last stage of the trigger. So then it's easy to close the door. Just you must find the right position, and then it's easy. So we will close the door, and then we will continue with the barrel. So if we want to take out the barrel, at first, we need to take out the silencer. Sometimes it needs more power to unscrew it, but it's also can be done by the hands. Then is the sleeve. Then you have this part with the Picatinny rail. So we must unscrew it at first these four screws. If you disassemble this part, so you must start from the right side to the left side. Then after you will assemble it, so you will change it. You will start from the left to the right. It's very important. So now we start from right side. It's very easy. To the left side. Also very important is when you assemble it, so please make the silencer very tight. It's about the balance of the barrel and it's very important for the accuracy. So we will take out the screws and take out this Picatinny rail. So now you can see the barrel and we will use a normal key number 14 and then we unscrew it. Normally it can be harder and then you can unscrew it. So barrel is take out. Now we want to take out the air tube. If you have still air in the air tube, so here you can see is the small key and you just a little bit unscrew and then the air go out. So it's also very easy. Now if you want to take out the air tank, so we must unscrew these four screws. Just a little bit unscrew. It's not necessary to take it out. And then you can unscrew the air tank. Sometimes the air tank can hold another aluminium part inside. So if you see that it goes all together out, so just screw it on the other side and unscrew it, and it will goes out just the tube. So now you have the air tube out, and you will take out this cover just a little bit. And then you can take it out. For sure, if you want to change the pressure gauge, it's very easy. Just put inside something, some big screw or something. We will use special tool, and then you will unscrew the pressure gauge. So you can see, it's very easy. And under the pressure gauge is O-ring. If there is some air leaking, please change this O-ring. If you want to take out this part, you can just unscrew it. And I will show you here. It looks like this. So you can also change the O-ring if there is some leaking. If there is a leaking during the filling of the air, of the pressure, so please unscrew also this screw and change the O-ring under this screw. It's very easy. And when you change the O-rings, please use some silicone or something like that. And then the O-rings will be better and will be more tight. So this is the part which is inside the tube. On the other side, you can see there is this special sleeve. And inside is a regulator. Regulator is here. And a lot of customers ask us how to increase pressure on the regulator, what they can do. So I will show it to you. You can use standard screw. Please hold from this position. You can see there is a position for the screw. So hold it and then you can turn it like a clockwise. So to the right. If you turn it to the right, the pressure go up. If you turn it back to the left, so the pressure go down. So it's simple and you can do it alone, but we set up the pressure on the regulator as on the best position. If we compare the air consumption and the power, so now we set up in the factory, I think that on the best position, but you can do it as you want. Yeah, so once more, if you turn it clockwise, so to the right, pressure go up, to the left, pressure go down. So this is about the regulator. And the other part is this one. If you want to unscrew this part, so please use some screw and then you can unscrew it. I will show it to you. So when we unscrew this part, I think that inside is very sensitive part. There is a spring and there is this needle with plastic part. A lot of customers ask us why we don't make it from the iron. It's impossible. It needs to be plastic because during the shooting there cannot be air leaking. So after a lot of shots you can change this needle, and also there is an O-ring. So if you have air leaking in this position, you can change it. You can see just take out this aluminium part and you will see the needle and you can change it. So if you want to take out the regulator from the tube, it's easy if you have an air tank. So please use some soft under the air tube, some soft part. Then and then just a little bit you will open the air of the tank. Then you will see now, after a while, yeah, so the regulator go out. Now you have the regulator out. If you have air tank, so it's easy and you can do it like this. If you not have air tank, so please use a hand pump or you must borrow it. Yeah, it's easy when you want to change it. So this is the regulator. Please don't open these sides. It's too complicated parts inside and it's not recommend to open this part. If there is any air leaking on the regulator, please change these O-rings and also check if there is no dust inside and so on. And in the video we will share the sizes of the O-rings in whole air gun. In each air gun you will get a service pack of the O-rings so you can change it. And if you already use it, so just let us know and you can buy it in our e-shop or we can send it to you. So now I will show you how to disassemble some parts on our tactical version. Tactical and standard version are almost similar. They have just different parts, the filling parts and the Kevlar tube or Kevlar balloon. And for sure the position of the pressure gauge is different. So here it is pressure gauge. And now if you want to take out the air tube, so at first you must take out all the air inside the tube. So you will unscrew the screw and all the air goes out. Then you screw it and then you can take out the balloon. So it's standard, and then you can see here it is one O-ring, second O-ring, so you can change these O-rings if you have some problems with air leaking. Then you will unscrew these four screws. So one, two, third one, and fourth one. Then you take out all the screws and you will take out this part. This is the same part, the filling part as on the standard version. It's a little, the shape of this part is a little bit different, but the function is almost same. So you can unscrew it and you can change the O-rings inside for sure. And then we can focus on this part. So there is a valve, and I will show it to you if it is disassembled. This is the part which is inside. You can see it, it is the same part, and this part is this one. How we take out this part, we normally use the air from the air balloon, and then it goes under the pressure, it goes out. So when it goes out, you can change the O-rings here, and you can check also this part. It's very easy. And it goes like this. So there is nothing special on the tactical one. There is just, as I said, there is just a little bit different in this filling parts, but you can see it's very simple and you can change the O-rings as you want. Love took us for a ride that we never dreamed.